Hi everybody, welcome! Yeah, let's paint together! Because this is going to be a kind of painting the same scene challenge, so I hope you are going to take on it. And I am so excited that this video is a collaboration with the wonderful, amazing Lindsay, the Frugal Crafter. A big welcome to Lindsay followers, welcome on board! I am so happy that you decide to watch this video and coming along. And I hope you will like my own little watercolor world and a creative channel. So we're going to paint the same scene in order to bring a bit our own take on it, and I hope this kind of challenge and collaboration can convey the idea that there is not only one way to paint well a scene, but that each can bring his or her own style, and that there are so many ways, as many ways I've spent in fact, to paint a scene beautifully. Hopefully. I am going to paint right now the lovely Portuguese scene we chose, and at the end of the video I will discover live Lindsay's painting, and it's going to be really fun and exciting to compare version and to see how she will have painted this lovely scene too. Let's get to the painting! Juicy, colorful, drippy loose watercolor! So wonderful! Oh, so here we are! I tried to put my palette in the shot so that you can see all my tools, brushes, water pot. I also picked my smaller additional palette because I think that's kind of orange on the boat, and this scene is quite a cadmium yellow orange, maybe the perfect hue, so I will use it too. And for my main color on my palette, feel free to check the video about the watercolor palette setup, and all my material info are in the kit I'm going to link in the description below. I had a lot of questions about the brush for the last video, so yeah, feel free to check it to have all the information about it, photos and links and everything. I took this photo in Portugal and the light was so beautiful, you know, this kind of stormy light, so I'm going to try to express it. I will try to describe what I am doing while I am doing it the best I can without being too long and too chatty, hopefully. I like that there are some white boats, which are going to be wonderful with negative painting. And I think I'm going to have fun, a bit of dripping the color in the water and trying to get all this atmosphere. But first, so my photo is just in here, that's why I am looking to the side. What should I start with? I usually like to start with my main subject and then grow the painting from it. And about the composition, I like for the photo, I want to have quite a high horizon with a bit of sky, and then the boats, and then just a bit of a foreground with the birds. And I may change a bit the scene, you know, maybe just slightly less boats, changing up a few things. Artistic listen, and we'll see how it goes. I will keep some white probably on even on the main colorful boats. Maybe I can just try to make the colorful strokes at the bottom of the boats, and then I will grow the sketch from here and make bleeding. I'm going to start with this gorgeous cadmium yellow orange, and just defining the two main boats. So want one rather big. And so to get the colors really pop and really strong, I will use some opaque, probably my opaque red and the blue too. So I'm not too much concerned about making this strong orange. I know that I will be able to put some color on the top if I want to. But this is a bit of the main shape of the main boat. Yeah, trying to give it a nice dynamic. And the second one. So we'll go for the blue afterwards, but maybe I'm going to drop a bit of red already, just for the color change. yeah, a bit of the water underneath in order to make the color bleed. So I am mixing, I want lovely blue-gray, a mix of ultramarine and transparent red oxide could seem logical for this kind of colors. But I also like these days my mix with phthalo turquoise. This blue is a bit purplish, so I drop a bit of purple in here. And I will play with color variations when painting. So I use this brush because it's newer than the other one, so for the good point of my Winsor I need to point it round. So I want to make a kind of nice, yeah, I think the color and value are quite a bit what I wanted to. So the matte is in here, so I have to keep the white negative painting to give the impression of it. And touching the color, try to make it bleed. I can. Oh, the blue is bleeding in the. In the orange, but not really the reverse. I am going to drop a bit of color in it so that it's a bleed like I intended to. Yeah, I like this shade of blue. Just dropped a bit more purple. So the same in here, I try to work quickly enough so that the edges are not going to dry, but I can re-wet them as I go too so that they don't dry too much. Even there, and because my color didn't bleed in the water, I'm going to do it. Sometimes you never know depending on how wet it is, and this is an opaque, so it's moves a bit less. So try to replicate the shape of the boat but upside down. And I am dropping a bit of red too. And so I am tilting my board so that the color is moving and bleeding and create some effects. My royal blue seems nice to have, so I don't want to get the boat too muddy, but yeah, probably I will add the blue later because it's going to end up like a mess if I do this too soon. So I think I have to hurry up with my water so that it doesn't dry too much. I would like maybe to play with bigger strokes too, kind of watery. And in the foreground the water is a bit lighter, so I'm going to play with these different values. And probably alternate watery brush strokes with stronger one. So I'm going to sketch a few boats to the right. So defining them with negative painting at the same time the top and the bottom. So I made recently a video about negative painting, so if you didn't check it yet, feel free to check it along with the big watercolor tutorial about defining shapes and focusing on what is important and all these kind of watercolor principles that are a bit of the base of my technique, trying to share them for the Direct Watercolor 2018 marathon. So here is for this boat with a hint of a mat in here. So this is not the easiest scene to tackle with direct watercolor without any pencil guidelines. But it's fun to do. And for the other boat, I want to have kind of really loose shape. Sometimes when I sketch a harbor or something, it's just kind of white shapes that will look like boats in the overall of the painting. So making it bleeding a bit, maybe strong pigments here and there. And so at the top, I will add a bit of the ground later. I will keep working on the water afterwards. For now, I am just kind of bleeding this. To add a bit of a warm glow to give the impression of kind of a stormy theme. So I usually like to use some moon glow for this kind of use. So let's pick a bit of moon glow as a base for my kind of lower sky. And so, yeah, I was saying I will add the background with kind of greenery later, but it won't be at all my main point. So now, plan for this boat. Then it can be the impression of the harbor. So I use a thinner brush to have so that it's a bit easier to define the mat. Then I am going to use a bigger brush to have to be able to make a nice swatch. So I said I would like to keep some white at the top of the boat, so I don't want to forget it. So always playing with a bit of color variation so that it adds some interest to the sketch. I like how the Naples yellow just bleeded in my water in here. So now brush switch. Big brush, just a bit of linking all these things together. So yeah, I know for now my sky is orange. And I am going to paint a blue wedding wet in it. But you know, this kind of warm light, I don't know if you can feel it in the photo, but yeah, I wanted to express this. And at some point I a bit of I thought it was a shame that I would a bit forgot to drop a bit of Naples yellow in the water. So I'm so happy that it's dripping right now, especially with putting my work at an angle, because it's going just to add just a slight warm to my water. So just perfect. I'm going to make my Naples yellow lighter and lighter. So I'm checking how dry my wash is, because I may try to use a bit of scraping for the ropes. But first, let's do a bit of wet in wet sky. So I am wetting the whole area with clean water. And now maybe with my sable brush, so that it's not too watery like a squirrel, I pick again some blue. Sometimes I add just a bit of transparent red oxide so that the blue is not too bright, too eye-catchy, but want it quite bright. And I'm going to apply it on wet paper, so that's why I want it a bit strong. I'm going to keep my work at an angle and working on the sky. This may be a bit too dark, I don't want it to be too kitschy. Sometimes the color, but it's going to be diluted with the water, and but I think this may be a nice kind of in the middle. And I keep defining the mats of the boat by putting some more darker color around to create some contrast. Maybe just a few more brush strokes and that's it. So it is dry in here. I don't know if it's going to be maybe a bit too late for my scraping. It's always easy to do everything all together. Let's try it. So, fidelity card. Yeah, that's nice. So I will have it for my main boat. Even almost, maybe, I don't know if it's too dry, too wet in here, maybe too dry in here, but the other side is still a bit wet. Quite a lot of ropes. I often make them quite loose, so even if they don't really connect exactly to the mat, it's just the impression of kind of these curvy lines, yeah, that help to have a sense of the boats. So I have another demo with scraping, which is called Urban Sketch Demo, Strong Light and Shadow, and I make this kind of scraping, fun scraping too. So I have the impression that the kind of combo between the warm orange color and the kind of blue purplish one works quite well, so I'm happy with that. I always try to work the most I can wet in wet or on wet paper. So I'm going to add a hint of the background now. I don't want it too green. I think I am more going to play with the atmospheric perspective and having it more kind of bluish. I can just pick a bit of green, but having it mixed with a really other hue. So I'm picking in my favorite green. Green Apatite Genuine, which create a kind of grey with the blue and purple I picked. And so the idea is to create a bit kind of almost a straight line in here, depending on how wet it is. even if it's not straight, I mean just a kind of sense of continuity so that you can get that there is something. Even if you don't really know if it's the sky, if it's the land or everything, what matters is the overall impression of light, of the boat as a subject. So don't want to overthink too much about putting your subjects and your big shapes in kind of boxes and separate them. I like to have them linked together and work more on the impression of the overall thing. So now maybe just some stronger darks at the bottom of this background. So I'm working on wet paper, so strong pigment so that doesn't bleed too much and it stays strong and at the place I am putting it. Yeah, probably not darker than that to get a sense of distance, but at the same time, because the boats are light, that's nice to have them in a dark background in some parts. And so there is a strong compact shadow just at the bottom of each boat. This one is still a bit wet. I'm going to start with the other one. I think I'm going to use a moon glow for the contact shadows. This is just having this line underneath, and it straight away gives you the impression of something on the water. So I can add just a hint of an impression of details. So for scraping, because it depends of how wet the paper is, can always keep working on it after a while, especially because the boat, so this was already dry. So yeah, I will work on this one when it will be dry, it will be more reasonable. And I have a bit of a problem with this boat, which is too high regarding to the what I did at the background, so I am thinking about it. I really want that to have this impression that the boat is under the water, of course. So, So I want to redefine it, maybe making it a bit higher, even if it's not supposed to have that shape. It happens sometimes with, you know, loose watercolor without any drawing. You have other priorities than the accuracy. You work on the impression, the dynamic, and sometimes these kind of things happen. And I will add again the contact shadow layer. To work on the foreground. I am wondering about the birds. They are cute, but sometimes too much things in the painting can be a bit too much. At the same time, they can balance a bit the painting. And I saw that on the photo, the birds are looking outside of the frame, which is not the best for the composition. I would rather like that they look at the boat, so the other side. And because making bird shapes are quite difficult in my opinion, and I was not sure about making them the reverse, I processed the photo, that's a bit of a cheating, to have the shape of the boat the other way. So I'm going to mix some goethite for this kind of warm foreground with a bit of quinacridone gold, maybe sometimes a bit of the green apatite genuine to have kind of greenish shade, but at the same time this nice granulation. So let's start with a warm color, and then I will add a bit of a hint of the pigment. And so just trying to get the shape of the bird with negative painting. Just think I would prefer to make them lose just a few kind of white shapes. Not trying too hard to make them look like birds. Sometimes it works better when you don't try too hard, because it shows when you try so hard, and it's maybe not the best. So this is a bit of the direction of the foreground. Just a few more white shape. Genuine creaminess. Also transparent red oxide and this kind of craziness. So maybe I should move a bit the paper
to encourage the effects and the pigment moving.
So I think that for the harmony of a painting, the foreground shouldn't have so much different color for the background, as this is more kind of orangey color. I'm going to drop a bit of this orange color in the foreground so that it's a bit of the same impression of a warm feeling. So a bit of the Naples yellow, or maybe just mixing some orange with the quinacridone gold and red. And dropping some cadmium yellow orange. I didn't splatter yet. What a surprising thing! I think I should. So here, this is the silhouette, so I'm going to make a few splatters on the wet paper, and then I will make a few more when it's dry. So just a hint of a shadow underneath the burls, or my kind of white shapes. The other things can be rocks, so, but this is not the main focus, so I want to keep this rather loose. Got some nice effect in here in the clouds. And so in these boats they often have some kind of bright touches, so I started to put a few things here and there. It works always really well to make colorful things. I already have a lot of warm color in here. Maybe the yellow, bright yellow thing in the photo. So maybe I can play with a bit of yellow. And a bit of my lovely turquoise. So to give the impression that maybe there is somebody or some colorful stuff, just something happening, because we simplify but that we don't want it to seem simplistic. So this kind of thinner strokes and details can be useful for this. I should try to evoke again a bit of the reflection of these boats. And if we wanted to make an impression here a bit more of white boat reflecting in the water, I could just work on negative painting again around these boats. And do that to get this shape of the reflection, but I don't want to darken too much the thing all around. I may use a bit of white for this one, straight from the tube. And also if I want to add a few ropes, because even with the scraping, that's a nice method, but you can't do it all with it, so sometimes just a bit of white can be a nice addition. Always use every tool possible, every opportunities to get the results right and to achieve it the way you want.
but slowly, all these colors and values reflecting in each other. I am looking forward to see Lindsay's interpretation of it. It's going to be quite exciting. We're going to discover it all together. Except if you come from a Lindsay video and you already saw her version. What is really nice with this challenge is, of course, this is no competition at all, that just each of us can bring our own style. I'm trying to share something useful, hopefully, for you. So I hope you will take something from both demonstrations and that it can help you to work on your style and enjoy painting even more. So seagulls, a bit of a grey wing. Blue-grey, and it can be a nice echo. So, as you can tell, this is really loose, but I don't want to define it more. And I talked about splattering when dry, so picking kind of a dark green. Work on the depth and sense of details with the splattering. Maybe a bit of a warm splattering too with transparent red oxide and the other warm color I used. Maybe a few bigger ones. So I make the sands melting in the water melting in the sands, because that's how it is. Tides and a bit of seaweed and water and everything, so I try to get this impression. Maybe even splattering a bit of purple of the water, purplish blue in here, to get this even more. This mixed impression, I mean this melted impression. So almost here, I just want to wait for the boat to the left to be totally dry to make the contact shadow underneath and maybe a few blue details on the boat, and I think that's it. So almost there. Touches, first the contact shadow for the big boat to the left. Here it is, and now a few details on the boat. So a bit of blue, maybe a bit of white on the big boat. So my opaque royal blue. I think this boat is almost... yeah, just to give a sense of this line. For the other one, maybe I can make a bigger blue line. And because I feel it needs a bit more light, maybe the my cadmium yellow, lemon yellow, this one, could add a sense of light. And you know, alternating with the cadmium yellow orange and the other one, just to get a nice color impression. I like that the birds are rather indefined, so I'm not going to add any details on here. I think I'm done. I think that's it. Probably the overall color scheme is a bit brighter than I was expecting, but I quite like the kind of alternating between purplish blue and orange and purplish blue and orange. I hope it works well for the harmony of the painting. Thank you.
with my painting of the boats, and now we're going to discover together Lindsay painting, if you haven't already, of course. So I think I have her email on my iPad, so I'm going to check it. I'm looking forward to see her interpretation. Where is the attached file? Oh, here it is. Touch to download. Oh, here it is. Yay! Wow, gorgeous scene! I like that you added the flying birds and wow, the color with the boat and the reflection in the water. I can see that she splatters on the sand too. Yeah, it works so well. Wow, that's so nice to have an interpretation too. And she gave a better sense of depth than mine, playing with the background. I a bit messed up my background, and that's why I had this problem with my boats. But yeah, that's really interesting. I think she used some ink to define a few things. Ooh, I like this challenge idea. That's just amazing. I like how her three boats make kind of a triangle, everything. That's so lovely. We would be really happy if you decide to paint this scene too. So it's going to be available at the link that we are going to display on the description box below. And you can use the hashtag I'm going to put just in here to share your own version, interpretation of the scene. So the idea is, of course, you can paint along with us, but try to put your own personality on it, and so that we can have more and more different interpretation of this scene. It's going to rock! Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Lindsay, to make this collab challenge with me. To my follower, please go watching Lindsay painting her own interpretation. I'm going to put her channel thing in here and the video so that you can watch her, and I am sure you will like her because she's as passionate and enthusiastic and lovely as I am. And if you are new to the channel, feel free to check a bit the video and subscribe if you like my style. I'm going to put my little own thing in here and maybe the video of my last big watercolor tutorial, just in case you want to go a bit deeper in my technique and get some advices, hopefully to improve your own art. Thank you everybody for watching this and sharing with us the passion of art and painting and watercolor, and see you really soon for more enthusiastic creative video. Bye!